हाँ अपना लाइव चालू हो गया।
ओके
अपना लाइव चालू हो गया।
कैन यू हियर मी नाउ? ओके हाँ
हाँ सही है।
ओके यू कैन हियर मी? ओके ओके
यस
ओके सो वेलकम बैक टू मटीन अमेरिका सीरीज रीलोडेड एंड अगेन वी विल लर्न टुडे अबाउट अ वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग रेमेडी एंड आई होप दैट टुडे वी आर एबल टू लर्न समथिंग इंटरेस्टिंग। कैन यू हियर मी? ओके डॉक्टर प्रतीक,
यस
द ऑडियो वीडियो इज ओके?
यस परफेक्ट
So I think today is interesting also because I have already given you guys the case for you to solve. And I hope that some of you have solved the case, hopefully. Have you done it? I can see some friends of mine here. So, have all of you got the case which we sent you actually 2 weeks back? Some of you have written the analysis as silica, and some of you have written the answer as phosphorus. Okay, let's do one thing. I will tell you the case and we will try to analyze the case together. Okay, so welcome back to Materia Medica series Reloaded. And every Thursday, 8:30, we will be discussing about a remedy. And I will be giving you the case beforehand. 2 days beforehand, I will be giving you the case. The case will be sent to you on the WhatsApp. So if you are on the WhatsApp group, join the WhatsApp group that Dr. Yash and Pratik have made. It's called as Materia Medica Series. There are 20 groups almost. And maybe Dr. Yash can send a link on the chat right now, maybe. And you can join that. And from that only, we will discuss the case. Towards the end, we'll kind of look at the analysis of everyone. And then I'll just share with you what happened to the case. Is that good? Say yes. आज सब सोए हुए हैं थोड़ा आईपीएल के चक्कर में लग रहा है ओके सो लेट्स स्टार्ट द केस सो आई होप आई एम गोइंग टू टेल द केस अगेन फॉर मेनी पीपल हु हैव जॉइंड दिस इज अ केस ऑफ अ 39 year old lady हु हैज asthma, कोल्ड एंड कॉफ ऑलवेज change of weather since 20 years allergic asthma since 20 years due to dust oily food strong smell acidic smell difficulty in breathing this difficulty in breathing is aggravated by walking fast by talking by exertion by lifting heavy weights lying down better by warm water and better by rest also there's a lot of body ache that our patient gets and the body ache there's pain all over the body pain especially below the knee till the finger the left hand is the main sensation is that of heaviness and there's a lot of bruised constant pain better by rest and pressure very peculiarly she gets pain in the left side and this is like a numbness of the left side where she cannot hold anything even a book for more than 5 minutes on the left hand strange it's a case of asthma but gives a very peculiar symptom that they cannot hold anything with the left hand due to the numbness on the left hand especially even for 5 minutes and it's better by movement past history recurrent fever with pain in the left side of the renal region already done a surgery of piles renal stone so many surgeries have been done looks like they haven't met a good homeopath till now finally they met one family history of asthma now we ask about the basic nature of the person the basic nature is that very calm very happy go lucky जो भी होगा देखा जाएगा विच मीन्स शी सेज दैट वॉट एवर इज देयर इट्स ओके नो प्रॉब्लम एक्सेप्ट्स एवरीथिंग नो स्ट्रेस लेट्स गो ऑफ थिंग लॉट ऑफ एंगर विद इन हर व्हेन वर्क इज नॉट डन ऑन टाइम व्हेन थिंग्स आर नॉट इन प्लेस व्हेन वर्क इज नॉट परफेक्ट बट इन एंगर She doesn't scream or shout. She's okay. She's calm. So her frequency and her pattern is not that of getting wild. She's calm. She's very sensitive of what others speak about her. How others speak about her. Are they rude? Are they offensive? She's very sensitive about it. Fear of high places, especially of water, of beach, of sea. No dreams particularly, no dreams. Stress, she says, no stress. I have no stress, Baba, no stress. Okay. Then I tried to probe more. Can you tell me some stressful situation? She says, yes, there was fire at home once, short circuit. But I was not much affected. I knew everything will be fine. I knew everything will be okay. And it was okay. She enjoys reading a lot and loves silent and very, very calm music. As a child, she was an extrovert, always with family and friends, and very, very mischievous and playful. And she loves spicy food, Italy. So a lot of my friends from Russia and Brazil have joined today, and even Switzerland, along with my favorite people, my own countrymen. So this is all Indian junk food, ragda pettis. Basically, I don't know how to explain it. You can just imagine potatoes being fried and put in with a lot of spicy things on it. Mango juice. Very thirstless, very chilly, not much sweat. Before menses, there is pain in the back, and during menses, also pain in the back. So this is the case in short. Are you all with me? I have about more than 250 participants watching live right now, and I'm hoping that some of you will tell me the remedy. Any suggestions, dear friends? Darius from Poland. Any suggestion? Do you want me to tell you the case again? Manganum, first suggestion, manganum by Nisha. Hi Nisha, manganum, remember the main symptom of manganum is embittered feeling. Lachesis, kotha. Okay, interesting. Riva says Sumbul, Sumbul umbelliferae family. Okay. Jose Monso, arsenic alb. Okay. Carcinosin, lachesis, pulsatilla, phosphorus, spongia. Rupal Bhatt says pulsatilla. RT, arsenic alb. Can I teach you something interesting, all of you today? Hello? Telma, phosphorus. Okay, I'll tell you the case again. So it's a case of 39-year-old lady with cold, cough, asthma, and lot of body ache, but says a very, very peculiar symptom that in all this asthma, which is very common, you know, weather change, everything is common. But there is a lot of numbness of the left hand. And when she told me, especially holding anything for a long time, she can't hold in the left hand, especially left arm, where a lot of pain. And a lot of surgeries done beforehand, a lot of history of family history of asthma. Very calm, relaxed, very relaxed person, doesn't respond too much, very accepting of situation, very easy going. Very angry, wants everything on time, wants everything perfect, very sensitive about what people say or do, very scared of high places. And stress also says no stress, whatever is there is okay, no problem. Extroverted. Playful, what is the reason for numbness? We don't know, Anjali. Cravings for icy food, spicy juices, and lot of pain before menses. Okay, so maybe we'll learn something new. So one of the top suggestion is phosphorus and crotalus. Yeah. And sulfur. Okay. Ruchi says sulfur. So I told you the name of my new book is Art of Refertilization, where I have explained almost eight different repertories. And this book will be hopefully be publishing this year. And extensively through the lockdown, I've been treating many cases of COVID, non-COVID, suspect COVID, many acute cases, difficult cases online. And just for last 6 8 months, we have been treating lot of cases. My work has almost tripled, and some of them have done well, some patients have done well, and I've documented these cases, and that is there in this book. So according to the new book, Art of Repertilization, which will be launched, whenever there is very peculiar local symptom, okay, and we don't know what to do. One of the best repertories to take is the repertory. I'm going to tell you a new repertory today. It's called as Nair repertory. Are you all with me? Say yes. Hello. Nair repertory. I'll try to read from a little bit from my book, huh? For you, all of you. Kahan pe ho? Okay. Nair repertory. Or maybe you like little bigger size. Nair repertory. This is Nair repertory. See the name of the book, A Repertory of Guiding Symptoms of Materia Medica by Calvin Nair. It is belong to a Puritan type of repertory, and it is based on herring guiding symptoms, which has many, many characteristic symptoms. And it is in pure clinical words, and that's why it is called as Puritan repertory. This repertory has many clinical rubrics, and it is when the level of experience is very low, especially where mind symptoms are not prominent, and a beautiful repertory where, especially where difficult cases are there. So, do you want me to show you what rubric I took? Say yes. Hello. Yes. So I opened the repertory like this. So you can see this. And then I type arm. And then I type numbness. Okay. And then I type pain. And then there is a very interesting rubric. Can you all see this rubric? Arm, numbness, painful, left, cannot even hold paper any length of time. Can you see the exactness? What the patient is saying, no story. No, that, oh, patient looks like phosphorus, oh, patient looks like arsenic. There is no looks like, there is exact. What patient says should exactly be there in our literature. And if you get that, then you will see the results are brilliant, absolutely brilliant. You can see this very, very beautiful rubric. Arms, numbness, painful, left, cannot even hold paper any length of time. One remedy only. Can you imagine? Can you even imagine? Think what remedy will be there. Okay, let me show you the remedy. It has only one remedy, and that is Medorhinum. So interesting, no? And now let's come back to the case. And now when you look at the entire rubrics again, the patient is very fastidious, lot of anticipation, wants everything in time, very, very sensitive to rudeness, desire for fruits, desire for juices, desire for all junk food. And you can see Medorhinum. And also the main idea is that acceptance, no problem, everything is okay. This is generally psychotic miasm. And then You can also see metronidazole is one of the main remedies for asthma, especially psychotic asthma, asthma psychotic. Now, you should also remember that the father also had asthma. So this means that there is a family history of asthma. Family history of asthma is generally psychotic miasm. Okay. Left-sided pain, also metronidazole. So I gave metronidazole 0 by 1, or as you know, I use a lot of LM1 or a lot of remedies nowadays in LM scale. Are you understanding something? Say yes. And this LM potency, the main advantage, you can repeat it very often. I use a lot in my practice, and after using LM potency, my results have improved a lot. So within 1 month, the body improved, and the left hand also pain improved by 30-40%. The nose block improved, and asthma, although it was not improving initially, was on aspirin pump, but gradually by next 2 months, the asthma was stabilized. First month asthma didn't improve, and next month it improved, and then it kept on improving. By third month was remarkably better, remarkably more than 70% better. The numbness went away, and a problem which was very, very chronic, very difficult, really beautifully improved with homeopathy. So welcome to today's talk, and welcome to the idea of metronidazole. Today we will study metronidazole. Are you all with me? Say yes. Hello. Are you getting an idea about metronidazole? Say no, because I haven't started explaining you actually. So today we learn about the drug picture of metronidazole, just metronidazole. This is from my book. I don't know how many of you have my book, Materia Medica of Nozodes and Sarcodes. So now the whole metronidazole I'm going to teach you through my book. Okay. And hopefully you will learn something. So all doctors who are watching my lecture right now, I want you to open the book Materia Medica of Nozodes and Sarcodes. Is it there with you? Hello? So just open the book Materia Medica of Nozodes and Sarcodes, and now I'll teach you step by step the remedy metronidazole. And today you will learn metronidazole, which you will never forget ever before. Okay? So metronidazole is one of the most neglected remedy in our cases. Why? Because very often nozodes are not coming in repertory sheet. In cases where you think it is phosphorus, little bit like calcarea, little bit like sulfur, little bit like causticum, little bit like pulsatilla, little bit like silica, when there is a mixture of different states, okay, when there is mixture of different states, and you are not sure, that is an indication for nozo. And it is specially very, very important remedy in chronic deep pathological case, especially where spinal cord and nervous system is involved, especially in women's cases, especially in chronic rheumatism, especially in chronic hormonal diseases. Many, many cases of PCOD, ovarian cyst, endometriosis, when your indicated remedy is not helping, think about metronidazole. Beautiful remedy. And today you will learn metronidazole like never before. And I hope that you are able to use it and help many people. The one thing that you will see if you study metronidazole from the repertory, and as you know, the way I understand remedies are very different way, because I have mastered repertory since last 10 years, different repertories. And I believe that every rubric you should be able to know. And because I've learned homeopathy and repertory from different methods, right from keynotes, from Kolkata method to ICR method, to Segal's method, to HHF method, to sensation method, to classical method, we are able to use all these methods together in practice. And that's why I'm teaching always the way I teach you remedy will be different, because I take all this together and teach. Okay. So Metronidazole, if you open repertory, there are more than 110 cravings. Can you imagine? So a person who is very, very undisciplined, indisciplined, very careless, and very typical wants Mumbaiya cravings, junkies, junk cravings, wants all junk food, that is Metronidazole. One of the biggest craving of Metronidazole is this carbonated drinks. So if your child wants Coca-Cola every day, think about Metronidazole. And you can see Metronidazole and phosphorus comes very close, by the way. Both want ice, both want cold drinks. So very often patients who don't improve on phosphorus or Metronidazole desire citrus food, especially green food. They will often say that they want curry. Very nicely. Desire for cold food. They want food, you know, they want all kind of cold meats, cold food. Desire for starchy food. Like pizza, pasta. Desire for a lot of fish. You can see this salty, spicy, roasty fish. Fried food, chicken lollipop. If your children want chicken lollipop, they crave chicken lollipop, think about Metronidazole. Fried chicken, remember, Metronidazole and Plumbum Metallicum. Desire for green fruits, sour fruits, kacha, raw fruits, raw things, Metronidazole. And this presentation is prepared by Dr. Juhi, so I want all of you to thank her for preparing this for me. Are you getting an idea? Say yes. Okay. Lot of desire for ice cream. Likes onion, but very often onion will aggravate their problems. Remember. Okay, orange juices aggravates. Desire for salads. They like salads a lot. Desire for salt. Whenever they are eating, they will add salt. Like Natrammure, like Corallium rubrum. Desire sweet and sour, jellies. They are people who love jellies. You know those jelly things. That is Metronidazole. You know, very often when I sit with someone to eat, I already know their remedy because I know what they are eating. Desire mixture of taste. So Metronidazole doesn't like one taste. They like mixture of taste. They want sweet, spicy, bitter all together. Interesting. This is beautifully law. Everything that I'm talking to you is there in my book, Nozode and Sarcode. I hope you have read this book. And if you don't have, you open the book right now. And while I'm teaching, you read from it. You will never forget it. Okay? Desire for tomatoes. Remember, desire for tomatoes. So even in all the food, it's even in pizzas, burger, everywhere, they want tomatoes in it. They will say, put some extra tomato. Very often, Metronidazole have sensitivity like pulsatilla, anxiety like arsenic, timidity like silica, sympatheticness like phosphorus, and sexuality like hyoscyamus. Very, very strong psychotic miasm, remember. You can see fastidious and insecure like arsenic. Hypochondriacal, you know, they small symptom, they'll think it's very big. Metrotinum. Very avarice. Cannot spend too much of money. I use metrotinum very often in cases of obsessive compulsive disorder. Constantly want to wash their hand. Constantly want to check the door is open. Especially middle-aged woman. Think about metrotinum. And when metrotinum fails, think about cefalinum. Learn these nozodes, my friends. Learn nozodes. All of you, learn nozodes and you will see your practice will improve. Also has qualities like causticum. They love being in nature. They love plants. They love animals. Like carcinosin. Huh? They just love animals. Very caring personality, metrotinum. Very affectionate. Constantly caring. But one of the main thing is about metrotinum is memory. They forget. They forget where they kept things. Where did they keep the table? Where did they keep the pen? Where did they keep the laptop? Oh, so if metrotinum is talking to you and suddenly there is a phone call, they'll open. Okay. And then they, oh, what was I talking? So they forget what they are talking if something comes in between. Loss of thread of conversation. This is metrotinum. Forgetfulness of what he's about to do. Forgetfulness of names. I forgot your name, Arey. What is your name? Forgetful of name of persons. Nainika asked me, are they jealous? Yes, they have animal qualities also. It's a mixture of everything. That is why it's a nozode. Forgetful for numbers. So children who are very bad at mathematics, like calcarea carp, think about metrotinum. Metrotinum very important for autistic children, ADHD children. Forgetfulness of what he has just read. Students are studying, they cannot remember. Give metrotinum one dose. Only if they are metrotinum, not to all children. Okay. Metrotinum will work very well when the patient is metrotinum. Forgetful of where they have kept things. Forgetful, अरे मैं क्या बोलने वाला था? What was I about to say? I was about to say something. I just forgot. What was I about to say? About Arnab Goswami, I was about to say. Cannot finish the sentence. Forgetfulness of words. Word hunting. अरे what was I about to... What is this called as? What is this? This is called as what? What was that called as? This is metrotinum. Constantly feel, I'm forgetting something. I'm forgetting something. Metrotinum. But there is a lot of, you know, this is what I want to tell you. There's a lot of perverted sexuality in metrotinum. Very vulgar and shameless. Very shameless. Perverted sexualities. They have inclinations towards homosexuality. Many, many patients who are coming to me, and nowadays I'm treating few page 3 personalities also. Many of them required metrotinum. Because they tend to hide their sexuality. So very important word is very secretive and very hiding nature. This is metrotinum. Are you all with me? Hello. Lot of themes of homosexualities, lot of perverted sexuality. They will experiment with sexual things. There is a very interesting rubric which I want to teach you, all of you. Just remember this rubric when you want to understand metrotinum, okay? Love for forbidden things. If you tell the child, don't do this, this is not very good. Don't have drugs. They will like it. This is metrotinum. Love for forbidden things. Remember this. I'm just reading from my Materia Medica book, which I've made. Materia Medica of Nozode and Sarcode. Beautiful. All of you open the book while I'm teaching. Someone asked me, differentiate Medorrhinum and Syphilinum. I will tell you. Medo is better at night and Syphilinum is aggravated at night. Okay. Easy. अरे हाँ तो बोलो. इजी. ओके लेट्स गो अहेड. वेरी सेक्सुअल. नेकेड वॉन्ट्स टू बी इन द स्लीप. दे कैन ऑल्सो बी वेरी वेरी इमोशनल, वेरी सेंसिटिव एट अ डीपर लेवल. वेरी वेरी सेंसिटिव लाइक पॉल सेटिला. They will keep crying while giving the history. This is Medorrhinum. Weeping, telling one symptom over again and again. They will repeat the same symptoms and keep crying. Are you getting an idea? Hello? Okay. Let's go ahead. Weeping on trifles, sometimes smallest thing, and they will cry. They are also very, very sympathetic and affectionate, like phosphorus. Very affectionate towards animals. They can be. One of the main symptoms, if I have to tell you, postponing. I will tell them, do the homework in 7 days. They will say, okay, I will do it later. And they don't do it. And they don't email me. So many of you should get Medorrhinum. Postponing. Baad mein, I'll do it later. Medorrhinum. Dr. Banerjee gives Medorrhinum in chronic renal failure as a protocol. So you should remember, Medorrhinum is very important in chronic renal failure. My guru, Dr. Sarkar, used to give Medorrhinum in congenital deformed cases. In children with cerebral palsy, he used to give Medorrhinum with serrated teeth. Very important symptom. Clairvoyance. They can feel things before. Oh, I think that lockdown is not going to open after 2 months, and still the lockdown will not open. This is Medorrhinum. They can see beforehand what it's not going to happen. Clairvoyant. Little psychologically very sensitive. Medorrhinum is a skin specialist. You know, if you want to be a very good dermatologist, Medorrhinum you should know. Many women during periods, after period, they have brown spots on the face. CPI is not helping. Think about Medorrhinum. And remember, red color warts. Okay? Think about Medorrhinum. Now, next, I'm treating many cases of PCOD and infertility. Okay? So, if any of you want my help in cases of PCOD and infertility, hormonal problems, endometriosis, I'm treating many cases. One of the very important remedy is Medorrhinum. Very important remedy. Because one of the important symptoms, menses, difficulty in removing the stain. That once the menses are there, it stains the cloth. And there is a lot of itching in the genitals. Better by bathing. acne in the face after menses, while magnesium has acne in the faces, acne in the face before menses. Many, I had a very interesting case of metrorhinum where pain in the ovary better by pressure. So many good cases. So ovarian cyst, okay, think about metrorhinum. My guru, Dr. Sarkar, used to give metrorhinum almost in many, many cases of infertility. He taught me this. My guru, Dr. Sankaran, he told me that metrorhinum, just remember, lot of anticipation, lot of avoidance. They want to avoid life. And lot of acceptance. This is very strong. This is the center of metrorhinum. There are people who anticipate, arre aisa ho jayega, aisa ho jayega, to aisa ho jayega, what will happen, then this will happen, then what will happen. They avoid, no, I will not go there, no, I will not go there, no, I will not talk to that person, no. And except, arre, whatever is there, it's okay, no problem. Take it easy policy. This is metrorhinum. Metrorhinum children, remember, I'm teaching you the way clinical materia medica, you will never forget. I want you to learn like this. Okay. So metrorhinum children, remember, the lips, very thick lips, very big lips, thick lips. Thick lips is metrorhinum. Mota, thick lips. There are red colored spider lids. So there are spidery eruptions, birthmarks, dirty nose. With discharges here. But the main symptom of metrorhinum, remember, sleep position on abdomen. If you get this, just give metrorhinum. Now, very important, I'm using metrorhinum in cases of post COVID, yeah, when the smell is going, okay, metrorhinum is a very important remedy in that, especially if the patient is metrorhinum. I used to give LM1, and we are treating many cases of COVID actually. And if any of you is treating cases of COVID or suspect COVID, and if you need my help in homeopathy, you write an email to me and I will help you out. Okay. Very often, metrorhinum has a unibrow, which means the eyebrows are joined like this. Tongue is very thick and coated. Remember, excessive thirst more than arsenic is metrorhinum. They have written burning thirst. Okay. And the teeth are yellow of metrorhinum. C.M. Bogar writes that metrorhinum has aphthae, very sore aphthae in the lips. Okay. And he also writes, very important for renal problems, better by urination. In cases of renal calculi, when all remedy fail, think of metrorhinum. Very important for dark, oozing, itching in the anus. Burnett says that there has been no case of sciatica, especially right-sided sciatica, which did not improve on glinicum. Glinicum is what he used to call metrorhinum as. Glinicum. Okay. Right-sided sciatica, you close your eyes. If patient sleeps on the abdomen, give metrorhinum. Don't even ask more questions. Okay. Nails are depressed as is bent. Are you getting an idea? Say yes. always better by stretching. Metronidazole always better after short sleep, like nux vomica and phosphoric acid. Even little sleep, they sleep for 1 hour and they feel, अरे बहुत देर सोया यार, आज 2 घंटा सोया. Very important, better by hard rubbing and stretching ameliorate. Also, remember, night ameliorate. Metronidazole people, they are more active at night. So I am not metronidazole because at night I get tired. I'm more fresh in the morning. I get up at 5 o'clock and I'm fresh and I'm studying and I'm walking and I'm doing. This is metronidazole. But metronidazole always night ameliorates. They're active at night. I had a patient of metronidazole who, as soon as sunsets, sunset ameliorate is very important for metronidazole. As soon as sunset, they used to get so much of energy. They used to go for parties, drugs, this, that. Did very well on metronidazole. Another very important symptom. Very, 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 very hairy metronidazole. Very, very hairy. Very hairy. Like Anil Kapoor, hair coming from the arms. So hairy arms, metronidazole. Hair on unusual parts. And that's why PCOD, remember metronidazole. Burnett has treated many, many difficult cases of suppressed gonorrhea with metronidazole. Dr. Swan has treated many, many cases of arthritis. It's very important, this remedy, especially where in there is a strong psychotic miasm in the family. Dr. P. Sankaran has given one case where the main symptom in a case of asthma was that the lady's breast would get icy cold. So he was given metronidazole. She was given metronidazole. Some black letter symptoms of M.L. Tyler. Time passes too slowly. Very important. Very, very hurried. Metronidazole is very fast remedy. It's not a very slow remedy. Yes, metronidazole can be a constitutional remedy. Why not? It can be a constitutional remedy. Differentiate with tuberculinome. Very important. The center point of tuberculinum is suffocation. They feel suffocated, they feel trapped, and they feel like doing something. While metronidazole, everything is acceptance, no problem. They are very careless, undisciplined people at times. Very important for infertility or azoospermia. Okay? Azoospermia, metronidazole. Beautiful, beautiful remedy. The main feeling of metronidazole is, I'm okay as long as my weakness is covered up. The main sensitivity is that they should not be exposed. They should not be criticized in front of people. That is metronidazole. Fear of being exposed. This is very important. I've written a lot. I've written many, many pages of metronidazole. I hope you read my book. Huh? Sutherland says cough aggravated by candies is metronidazole. And Boger says metronidazole is very important for vomiting in pregnancy. Cough which comes after any kind of viral illness. Remember four remedies. Tuberculinum, bacillinum, metronidazole, influenzinum. I've written about all this. Please open and read my book, Nozod and Sarcode. It's so long because, you know, my next lecture is of my friend, Dr. Pratik. So I don't want to take up his time. So I'm going to just skip a few slides. One very important symptom I will just tell you before I finish, that they have, in this case, very important for plantar fasciitis. Especially in cases where patient tell that they get heel pain as soon as they get up in the morning, as soon as they keep the feet on the heel, there is pain. That is metronidazole. Okay? Read it from repertory. I have given many, many times. Okay? And lot of that discharge, like leucorrhea, okay? Like menstrual problems, like sweat. They have fishy odor. This is metronidazole. So, I hope you read both my books. My book, one is on Materia Medica of Nozodes and Sarcodes. One is Decoding Mental Rubrics, where I've explained almost more than 1,000 mind rubrics from all repertories. So I believe that you should read both the books. It will help you. It's okay if you don't read also, but it will help you. So this is my email ID. If you need books, you can write to me or you can write to Dr. Prateek Jain also. And my homework for today, what is my homework? So the homework for today, read Medorhinum from Allen's keynotes, from Clark, from Kent, from Tyler. Okay. Read all the four books and then email me on my email ID. And then write to me five things that you learned in my today's lecture. Okay. So there are almost 400 people who are watching me live right now. I want that you write to me about this. So write down my email ID, write to me what you learned. And all of you, every single person, go back, read my book, Materia Medica of Nozodes. Most of you have my book. Read Medorhinum, read Syphilinum, read Tuberculinum, and then differentiate. Okay? So I'm going to just now finish my talk for today, and I hope we can meet again next Thursday. Yeah? And finally, if you have any COVID cases or suspect COVID cases, you need my help, you can write an email to me and I will help you. And or any kind of emergency cases, I will help you. Okay? So, anything, Prateek? Can I go from the screen so you can teach now?
Yes, no problem, yes.
Okay, so I will do stop sharing. See you again. Listen to my friend Prateek. He has very good ideas today to share. And write to me what you learn. See you later.
Okay.
Nikal gaya.
Okay. Share screen. Okay, so can you all see my screen? Just a second, let me check. Okay, yeah. Very good evening to all the participants. My audio and video is okay. Yes, okay. So I'll be sharing a short case with you all. So this was a case of a 28-year-old male patient, and it was a case of chronic headache. The main thing was he used to get this frequent episodes of headache, and which used to last for at least couple of days whenever he used to start having these headaches. And the main thing in this headache was he had a throbbing kind of pain. He used to say ekdam jhapakta hai, ekdam throbbing kind of pain, especially in his forehead. And whenever he had a lot of pressure from his work, at that time this headache used to get worse. Because of this headache, he was not able to concentrate on any kind of work, and his whole day used to get wasted behind this. And he used to feel better whenever, like, he had headache. He used to go out and used to take a walk in open air, and after that he used to feel better. So this was his main complaint. Along with this headache, he had some other complaints like sleeplessness. Sometimes he used to get itching on the skin, but that was just like he didn't had any eruptions or any kind of thing. Just there used to be itchings. And he used to feel that because of a lot of stress about work and other things, he was losing his hair, and his appetite had also decreased because of that. His concentration level had also gone down. Earlier, he used to remember all the things, but recently he started forgetting things. He was not able to concentrate on a particular topic, on particular work or anything. He had to make a lot of efforts for that. So normally, how do we see? So in each type of cases, we can take different approaches, whether be it acute case or chronic case. So every time it is better to try and probe deeper into the case. So even if it is a headache, we try and see what is the exciting cause of this, what is the main thing behind this particular complaint. So I asked the patient like how all these complaints started and all. So he said that 6 months back all these complaints started, and he had a lot of work pressure because that in his office the manpower was less, and he had a lot of work on his shoulders, and he used to make sure that each and every work is done perfectly. And he, because of all this workload, his traveling had also increased. So a lot of mental exhaustion was there. And he felt that earlier he used to be very excited for his work, but now, and he used to make sure that all the work has been done in a proper way. But now he feels that he is not able to do it properly. There is not proper structure of the work. He is not able to make that. And because of that, he somehow feels that why I'm not able to do it. So I asked him about his nature, and he told about this thing about his anger came up. And he says that whenever, if I don't have any fault and if someone tries to put me in that place, then I feel very angry. And even if when there is a fault of my some known people and which I cannot point out, I feel very angry from inside. So what does he do in anger? How does he react? So he punches on something. And sometime what he does is he will write down all the things and then he'll burn the paper. So after that, he feels very better, very light. So this is the way of expression of his anger. Screen, some participants are writing, screen is not clear. Is it okay now? Can you see the screen properly? Yeah, I think it is perfect from my side. Yeah. Okay, so we'll go ahead. Okay, so I asked him what are the things that matter to him most in life. So he says that family matters to him a lot, love and his work. So what about family? So he feels that family, like everyone, they are an integral part. Family is always with you. They will never drop you and move on. They are there from the start. And for this, he believes that complete trust is very necessary, especially from all the family members. So there was one incident once when his mom kind of, because of some reason, he was not at home, that he was working or something. So he was late in coming home. So mom called her friends and his boss to check out. So he felt very bad that you should have trust on me. Okay. So we go to another area. So we ask him about his dreams. Does he get any dreams? So he says, yeah. So one dream which he used to get was falling from horse. So after that, he gets hurt and there he used to get stitches and all. So that was there. The second dream was he used to get bad dreams like all the bad things which had happened earlier. Another dream was when he is looking at his engineering mark sheet, he is crying looking at his marks, and he is telling lies to his families and professors and everyone regarding his marks. Another dream was dreams of embarrassment. In that dream, he felt very embarrassed and he used to curse himself. He was beating himself. And another dream was falling, dreams of falling from stairs. So these were a few dreams which he had. So I asked him about his fears. What fear does he have? So he says, the biggest fear which I have is making wrong decision and losing whatever I have made. So we ask him further, like, what is the exact fear in that? So he says that whatever I have made, everything will be gone. I will be left with nothing. No one around me would be only left with few material things, and material things don't matter to me. So that was his only fear. Occasionally he used to get itching without eruptions, and he used to get a lot of perspiration on slightest exertion. Little exercise he does and he'll be drenched in sweat. Thirst is more, spicy food aggravates, and he had a strong craving for sweets and chocolates. So this was the case, more or less. So the patient came with a complaint of headache, chronic headache, and his headache was worse. Especially he had this throbbing kind of pain in forehead, and he used to feel better whenever he used to go out, take a walk and move about in open air. And he had some other complaints of stress, concentration problems, itching of skin, sleeplessness and all. And all this started because of workload, lot of work pressure, exertion and all those things. We saw about his anger, how he used to react, how he used to respond in anger. He will burn the paper and he will write down things, all those things which make him feel angry, and he will burn those things, and that's how he'll feel better. He'll punch on something and then he'll feel better. Important things in life, he family is very important to him, and he feels that all the family members should have trust on each other. That is very important. And he had few dreams of falling from horse, some dreams of embarrassment, dreams of falling from stairs, and dreams of weeping and so on. Skin complaint and few general symptoms. So how do we analyze this case? So we tried to probe as much detail as we could get from the patient. Now we have all those information available with us. Now how do we analyze this case? Okay. So we have few suggestions from participants. Someone says argentum nitricum. Okay. One of the participants says natrum tarantula nux vomica. Okay. Some more suggestions. Argentum nitricum, okay. Yes. Workload, lot of pressure. So argentum nitricum, okay. Belladonna, okay. Chief complaint of headache, we give belladonna. So more or less, see, these are the things, these are the few options which you gave. I'll also think and analyze in the same way when I do it. So normally acid foss, Kali family, yes, okay. Fourth row remedy, mineral kingdom, natrum. Okay, so we have many suggestions. So normally what we try to do in cases is, if the symptoms are available at a deeper level, we first try to analyze and find a remedy at deeper level. So we saw that this particular patient had a lot of dreams and all. So we try to get an entry into the case from a deeper level. So when we see For example, dreams of falling from horse. So we have this remedy tarantula. So one of the participants wrote tarantula. But do we, looking at the case details, do we feel that this picture of patient will match tarantula? This patient will help by this remedy tarantula if we give him. So, yeah. So I also felt the same, that okay, even if this particular symptom is covered by this remedy, the entire picture of tarantula, what we know about the remedy tarantula is not at all matching this patient. So even if we give him tarantula, it won't help. So what I did was I tried to take some symptoms from the case, his dreams of falling from horse, dreams of embarrassment, weeping, his cravings for chocolate, then increased thirst, itching without eruptions, his headache, better by open air. So when we repertorize the symptoms, we get all these remedies, arsenic, pulsatilla, lycopodium, phosphorus, alumina, natrum, mur, sulfur, mesarium. So now which remedy do we give out of this? That is the question. So out of these remedies, which one do you think will help the patient? Should we give him arsenic or pulsatilla or lycopodium or phosphorus or alumina? Which one out of these do you feel will help the patient? Okay, CPR. Maybe CPR possible. Natrum mur, okay. Okay, so that is the thing. So I tried giving 2-3 remedies from this repertory sheet. When we analyze the case, I try to give a few remedies to the patient, but none of the remedies help the patient. And when we see at the overall picture of the case, see, whenever we take a case in little bit depth, we get a fair hint about what is the kingdom of the patient, which family the patient looks like, and something comes up, and then we can correlate with the symptoms. So at one side we have this system part, on the second hand we have symptoms, and we can become very much sure of our prescription. But in this particular case, I was not sure what exactly, even if the patient was little bit at a higher level, but I was not getting the exact picture what it was. He was talking, sometimes he was talking about structure, sometimes he was talking about trust, care, all those things. Then again, he was talking about something else. So there was not a clear hint of any particular kingdom in this case. Yeah. So that is the idea. When you don't get any clear hint of any particular kingdom in the case, you don't get single kingdom, you are not able to narrow down, right? Okay, this patient belongs to this particular kingdom, or you are not able to make a totality, nothing is matching. You will get, as we saw earlier Madorinum case also, you are getting all those remedies, but even after giving those remedies, the patient is not getting improved. So what I did was, in this case, after failing, you see, you won't be getting direct results in all of your cases which you are treating. In many of the cases, you will get failure, but eventually you will learn from all these failures. So when I tried giving him 2-3 remedies after failing, I thought, now what else can I do? So what I did was, again, I went to his case and I try to analyze from a different angle. So normal thing which we do, I already did, but now this was not helping. So what I did was, first I took only his headache totality, specifically headache, what exactly was there. So again, I went to the symptoms case and I saw. So what was his main thing? That is, headache was there because of lot of work pressure, lot of mental exertion. that had caused this, made this headache worse. So I took that. And where was the headache more? It was more in forehead, throbbing kind of pain. And how he would feel better? He would feel better by walking in open air. He used to go out and he used to take a walk. After that, he used to feel better. So when I take only this totality, this headache totality, nothing else. So again, we saw Natremure, Phosphorus, Lycopodium coming up, Sepia. But you also see another remedy which is coming up, and which was something known as, which was giving us an entry into the case. And it entirely gave us a new aspect, new kind of thinking in this case. So this thyroidinum remedy came up. Mind work impossible during carbovers. Okay. Yeah. Craving for chocolate. Okay. Okay. So this was, after taking this headache totality, I got a slight hint of thyroidinum. So what I did was, then I started looking into the other symptoms, what I could see. So it also had strong craving for sweets, itching without eruptions, and profuse perspiration on slightest exertion. So again, we see thyroidinum. So when we take this overall totality, a different totality, we are not taking the mind symptoms, we are not taking the dreams and all. So when we take this particular totality along with the general symptoms, now when we see, so we are getting this indication of this remedy, thyroidinum. And normally I would have not thought of thyroidinum for a headache case. I would also initially start with belladonna or something like the remedies which are commonly known for treating headaches. So I would have gone for those remedies. But this was something after failure of using 2-3 remedies which were fairly indicated, but it didn't help. So I thought of taking a new approach and came up with this remedy, thyroidinum. So repertory, okay, this is a complete repertory, and this is from Synergy software which we use. So the case was analyzed using a complete repertory. We use, in certain cases we use smaller repertory, SCAN, BBCR, FATAC and all. In certain cases where we need a bigger repertory, we go for complete repertory. So thyroidinum, I gave him normally Nozode and Sarcodes, we give 1M potency, higher potency maybe, and sometimes LM potency. So I gave 1M AD4BD2, means two doses twice a day. Okay, so just after giving thyroidinum, and I waited for 1 month, and when I took the follow-up, his headache was much better, his sleep was better, his hair fall was better, skin complaints were better, his mind state, moods, everything was better. His concentration, he was now much able to do, he had a good concentration while doing work, and he was not having any dreams. So that was, see, earlier I gave other remedies, but it was not at all helping patient in any complaints. But after giving thyroidinum, his other complaints were also improving. So this gave me an idea, as we have been regularly learning from Dr. Gaurang. We have been seeing in many cases where normal remedies don't work, where there is a kind of block. You are not able to move ahead. You are giving different remedies, but it is not helping. So in that type of cases, you can think of Nozodes and Sarcodes for that particular case. So in this case, thyroidinum helped us. So let us today study little bit about this remedy thyroidinum, and try to understand what kind of picture we can see in patients. So as Dr. Gaurang already said, this book Materia Medica of Nozode and Sarcode, I think it's a wonderful kind of gem, and one of the only books where a lot of information is given about all the different kinds of nozodes. I think around 20 to 25 nozodes and 20 to 25 sarcodes remedies are given in this book, and he indication when to use them, what kind of. So in one of the chapters, it's very beautifully explained when to use sarcodes, So when there is a lack of reaction and we need to stimulate a particular organ or a particular hormone in an individual, we can think of using this sarcodes. When you see a lot of alteration in mind state, in many of the cases we have seen that patient has alternating mood states. So where you have this kind of alteration at mind level or at physical level, you can think of sarcodes. Either there is a lack or there is an exaggeration of function of a particular organ or system. In many cases, we can use it as intercurrent remedy. And there is always a possibility that after giving this remedy, either nozor or sarcode, you may or you may not need a different, deeper acting remedy. We call it as constitutional remedy. But even nozors and sarcodes can be constitutional remedy. So that we have to keep in mind. And especially in different kind of hormonal disorders, these nozors and sarcodes play a very important role. So whenever you think of nozods and especially now sarcodes, so you get an idea when to use this kind of medicines, in which type of cases. Okay, someone was asking which remedies were given earlier. I exactly don't. One of the remedies which I remember was Pulsatil I had given, which was coming in the repertory sheet. So Pulsatil I had given and couple of more remedies in this case. So let us now try to understand thyroidinum. Some few little introduction about this remedy, thyroidinum. So basically, this remedy is prepared from thyroid gland of domestic sheep. And when you read this particular remedy, thyroidinum, in nozods and sarcodes book, the main thing genius about remedy, this thyroidinum remedy is given. So as you read in the beginning, it is written, the genius of this remedy is functional imbalance in metabolism. Either you will see excessive fast-paced or slow-paced reactions at all level. Either general, physical, or everything. So as we saw, there is a kind of polarity. Either you will see a lot excessive fast pace. On the other end, there is a possibility that you will see very poor reaction, very slow pace. So this is a kind of polarity you will see. And also already we know, you can also see alternating mood states. So that kind of states you will see in thyroidinum. So that is the genius of this remedy. So thyroidinum is mainly connected with all the three elements of organism, physical, vital, and mental. So many of the allopaths, they used to give thyroidinum in crude form in cases of cretinism, where the child is not developing both mentally and physically. The growth is retarded. The child remains dwarfish throughout his life. And in many cases of myxedema also. So this remedy is very useful, thyroidinum. One of the important sphere of action of this remedy, thyroidinum, is on heart. Apart from other systems of the body. And normally, in many cases, it has been seen that it affects left side more prominently. And you will see in lot of cases, in some cases you will see the patient is very emaciated. On the other hand, in certain cases you will see there is lot of obesity, lot of puffiness, swelling of the body. And the patient will feel very, very lethargy, dull, lot of loss of energy. He'll feel completely exhausted, wants to lie down on the bed. Extremely tired, and you can imagine fainting kind of thing. as we already studied, it's very good for growth development. So whenever in cases you see children where there is this development is arrested, we can think of this remedy thyroidinum, and it's one of the specific remedies for undescended testes. We have seen many masters, many teachers giving this remedy for undescended testes with the beautiful results. They have a lot of headache, persistent headache, especially in the frontal areas. They'll feel a lot of heaviness there, over the head, over the eyes. And whenever they are indoor, their nose is very dry. As soon as they go out in open, the nose starts running. So that is also a very peculiar symptom of thyroidinum. They have a very strong craving for sweets, very, very, very strong craving, and also for cold water. And it's one of the very good remedies, especially for vomiting in pregnancy. Okay, if one of the important physical symptoms is coldness of hands and feet. Their hands are very cold and clammy. And you will see the glands, all the glands, they are very, you will see especially glands of stony hardness in thyroidinum. And this is a very beautiful remedy for infants, newborn child, small children. So whenever you see a different kind of pathology, some strange pathology or something like that of children, and where there is a thing about life and death situation, thyroidinum is one of the remedies we have to keep in mind, especially where it is the vital force is affected a lot, and it's there we have to think, keep in mind this remedy, thyroidinum. So especially when we see cases of newborn where they have convulsions, which is not due to any trauma during delivery, and where there is no the rise of temperature, you can think of this remedy thyroidinum. It will give you very good results. And as we saw, it's a very good remedy for vomiting. So vomiting and nausea with any kind of chronic disease is one of the keynote symptoms of thyroidinum. And in cases where after the delivery on second or third day, there is a toxic vomiting, and it's kind of a situation like where the baby is at the stage, death stage, there is a deathly pallor, extreme prostration. So you can think of this remedy thyroidinum, you have to keep in mind. Okay, so in Ghosh Drugs of Hindustan, it's very beautifully given that in desperate cases of jaundice of newborn babies, thyroidinum will bring back the patient almost from the jaws of death. So you can imagine how beautifully this remedy works. So whenever you see in newborn patients jaundice, you have to keep in mind remedy thyroidinum. So in ordinary cases, he reads, in ordinary cases, natrum salve, china, etc. may help the patient. But where the life of child is at stake, you have to think of thyroidinum. So that is the difference. So normally you can think of other remedies, natrum salve, china, etc. But where there is a stake of child's life, you have to think of thyroidinum. It's a very good remedy for all the menstrual complaints, menorrhagia, metrorrhagia, amenorrhea. So it's very similar in action to like lachesis. They are complementary. So it's a complementary remedy to lachesis. So whenever, especially it's a very good remedy for menopausal age. So in one of the books of Dr. Sankaran, Nozodes, Dr. Sankaran's notes on Nozodes, it has been written that it is found very useful in cases of urticaria, angioneurotic edema, and it's one of the very good remedy for diabetes mellitus, where the symptoms appear with great rapidity and there is a lot of weakness. Along with that, you have diabetes mellitus, think of thyroidinum. And it's a very good remedy where there is defective secretion of milk during lactation, and which is related to the reappearance of menses. So when you give thyroidinum, it will suppress the menses and it will increase the milk flow during the lactation period. Okay, so we saw all the indications of thyroidinum, in what type of cases or what type of symptoms we can think of thyroidinum. We saw different headache, in nose complaints, cold coryza, when to think of cravings, the physical symptom, coldness of hands and feet. In which kind of children cases, infant cases, it will be helpful. So any kind of pathology which is there in newborn, either convulsions, jaundice, vomiting, and so on. So thyroidinum is very useful, especially where there is life and death situations. So you can think of jaundice. You can think of thyroidinum. Then we saw about menstrual complaints, diabetes, and so on, lactation. Now, when to not use thyroidinum is also important. That is also something which we should keep in mind. So it's written in Boric that must not be given in physiological doses where with feeble heart there is high blood pressure, and not in tubercular patients. So in these two type of cases, these two type of patients, you should not give this remedy where the patient has heart complaints, lot of high blood pressure, or tuberculosis, tubercular patients, you should not give thyroidinum. Because this drug, why we should not give? So it is written in NM Chaudhary, you can read, this drug is contraindicated in tubercular patients, for it may most likely bring about further reduction of weight. That's why you should not give this remedy. So we normally keep in mind what are the indications of remedy, when to give, but in certain remedies where our masters have mentioned specifically, we have to be cautious. So we have to keep those points also in mind. So in this type of cases, we should not give thyroidinum. Okay, so clinical tip by our master Dr. Sarkar. So sir says, when you see that there is allergy specific more prominent in the case, patient is not able to tolerate this, not able to tolerate that, and when you go into the past history of patient and you see that patient had lot of allergies to different kinds of food, different kinds of chemicals, odors, etc., or having asthma or urticaria in the past, one of the important remedies you have to keep in mind is thyroidinum, where there is lot of history of allergies that is there. So he has, you will see a lot of symptoms of very easily tired, fatigue, extreme chilliness, shivering. So normally these are symptoms of hypothyroidism, but it also, you will see those symptoms in thyroidinum. So he has given an idea. So when you see a patient with lot of history of allergies, patient looks like calcarea, and he has vasomotor affections. So these are the main keynote or indications of the remedy thyroidinum. So okay, so finally, when we have to read the gist of the remedy, when we have to see, so it's very beautifully explained in this particular book, Materia Medica of Nozodes and Sarcodes by Dr. Gaurang. So in this, you see the entire, we can see, we'll read together. the constitution of thyroidinum. So physically, how will be the thyroidinum as we saw? Either he will be very lean or he will be very obese. Very chilly with prominent eyes. Lean or obese constitution. Especially babies with twitching, convulsions aggravate, cold water. Okay, in opium we have warm water bathing aggravation. In this we have cold water aggravation. You will see lot of aggravation from cold. There is a strong desire for sweets, cold and clammy, perspiration of hands and feet. They are very suspicious in nature. Violent. Violence, anger, okay. Especially during menses. Lot of history of allergies. Lot of dyspnea without apparent cause. And it's very clinically specific for vomiting during pregnancy when all other remedies fail. So it's a kind of a short brief about this remedy you can keep in mind. So when you're thinking, you can when you get this kind of symptoms, you have to keep thyroidinum remedy in mind. And certain symptoms from Fatak are given in these books, confirmatory symptoms which we can check. So first we already saw suspiciousness, then itching without eruption. So one of the participants had written about this symptom. So it has many other remedies, but one of the remedies when we can think of when we get this symptom is thyroidinum. They are better by lying on abdomen. You will see a lot of weakness and prostration. They are very lethargic, not able to move, just want to lie down. Strong craving for sweets with weakness and obesity, persecution of ideas. So these are the idea, main few peculiar symptoms which we have to keep in mind while thinking of thyroidinum. So these were some hints, some idea about the remedy thyroidinum, which I learned from different Materia Medicas and especially from this book, Materia Medica of Nozodes and Sarcodes. So as we already know, it has been helping many of you, all the beginner practitioners all as well as the senior practitioners. So it's a wonderful gem kind of book. And this were I think just today Dr. Gaurang taught us Medorinum and this thyroidinum. So these are just few couple of remedies. It's a huge ocean of knowledge of different kinds of nozodes and sarcodes. You must have not even heard of many of them. So I think it's very good book each one of us should have. And many of you already, I know you have these books, some of you who are new to our MM series. So if you want to get your book of nozodes and sarcodes, you can write to me, you can email to me on either drpratikjain@gmail.com or thehomeopathichub@gmail.com, and we'll help you with the books. Also regarding today's session, you can email me your feedback, your queries or anything. I would try my best to help you out. And let me know how did it go today, how was today's session, and see you all on next Thursday, 8:30 p.m. Indian Standard Time with another interesting session of Materia Medica series with Dr. Gaurang. Till then, take care. Bye-bye. Have a nice evening.